Those of you that don't know, my mom was an immigrant. She came here from Morocco. My dad, which some of you know, but I don't know, school all in Illinois. Went from high school to the Air Force. I was actually born at an Air Force base in Louisiana, raised by my mom. And, you know, she sacrificed a lot to give me a lot of opportunities. You know, on paper, I don't have the pedigree maybe that would dictate that I would have to do this job. And I considered it an honor, truly for the first time. And I feel like the first day I walked in this building as a legislator. And, you know, I like to tell people that I was sworn in on Tuesday, but I changed the world by Friday. And I kind of came up with that attitude. But I remember just being struck with a sense of awe, kind of feeling, you know, when a little kid sits on Santa's lap for the first time. And, I never lost it. You know, I walked in the building today knowing that, and it was going to be the last day I came into the building as a legislator. But I still had the same feeling from when I first walked in, that it's just been an actual privilege and honor. Not the title so much, but the job and the responsibility, the people that I've gotten to serve with. It's been a long time. You see a lot during those years. You know, we've seen the lows in this body. I've seen us lose some good people. I remember when we lost Terry Durant, when we lost Tim Osmond. And there's nothing worse than seeing the bumping on these chairs, and those of you that haven't seen it, I hope you never do. At the same time, you see some real high points. You see people have milestones in their lives. There's birthdays, weddings. You know I've been here a long time. You know, when Kevin got here, he barely had enough kids for a 3-on-3 team. Well, now he can build his own baseball team. But you realize that, you know, what we do here is part of something bigger. Sure, we're all elected to represent our constituents, and we do that to the best of our abilities. And you know, I've tried to do that to the best of my abilities. To the extent that you talk about the passion I bring to the job, I believe in this job dirty. If I've ever offended anybody by my passion, I apologize, I assure you that it really was trying to do what was right. And I may not always be right, but I always did what I thought was right. And I realized along the way, and I learned so much during this job, that you cannot ask anybody, and I hope you remember this, you cannot ask anybody to show you any more respect for your opinions than you're willing to show them for theirs. And that's led me to be able to work with my friends from downstate, from across the aisle, from this side of the aisle, on issues that you agree with and issues that you don't, and reaching compromises. Yes, being able to fight to the end on this house floor with somebody and go out and have dinner with them that night and realize that you're both trying to do the job to the best of your abilities, and that's what we're here to do. Been doing this after 14 years. As Sarah mentioned, my daughter was born less than a month before my first primary. She's now 14. As I tell people, she didn't want me around less, but I want to be around more. So yes, I'm leaving on my own terms. It's bittersweet. This has been just such a privilege and honor and joy to do and to work with people. So many of you, we never would have met each other. Not just me and you guys, but you and each other. We never would have met each other, but for this job. And the people I've met, the places I've been, the things I've learned, the things that I never would have had occasion to come across, but for the privilege of serving in the General Assembly. And that's something that I will always be thankful to my constituents for, and to all of you for, truly. I guess let me just say this. The partisanship kind of comes and goes here. And I think that, all too often, I think we focus on the aisle in the middle of this body as something that divides us. I think the more important feature to look at in this room isn't the aisle, but the door to this chamber. When we come through that door, we're united in a duty and a service to the people that we represent. and to the people of Illinois. For 14 years, I've tried to do the best that I could to represent those people well, to work with you so you can represent those people well also. Thank you for letting me work with you. Thank you for the opportunity and the privilege. God bless each and every one of you. God bless your families, and God bless the people of the state of Illinois.
The House Resolution 1245.